Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I will show you how to customize column data and headers, and how to add a custom toolbar in the Angular Gantt chart component using templates. First, I open my existing application, where I have installed the Angular Gantt package, and all the modules of the Gantt chart are configured in the App module page. In the App component HTML page, I have added the basic rendering code of the component. In the data.ts file, I define the hierarchical object, project new data, with a collection of tasks. I added fields like task ID, task name, and so on to a single task. I also added the subtasks field to define child tasks. I added other tasks as well, with appropriate parent and subtasks. In the app component class, I have assigned that object to the variable data. In the appComponent.html page, I assign that data object to the DataSource property of the Gantt chart component. I map the DataSource fields to the component using the task fields property. And I have displayed selective fields using the eColumns tag. You can refer to my Angular Gantt chart getting started video to learn more about configuring the component. I've shared a link to it in the card above and the description below. Let me run this application. See here, the left pane has a tree grid with hierarchical data, and the right pane has a chart with a project timeline to represent the project duration. First, I will show you how to customize the column data using the column template. To demonstrate this customization, I need to allocate resources to the Gantt chart. Resources are JSON objects that contain an ID, name, unit, and a group of resources. In the data.ts file, I have added the object editing resources, which has fields like resource ID and resource name. This collection needs to be mapped to the Gantt chart control using the resources property. Notice the object project new data contains resource IDs in each task. Open the app component class and import the editing resource object from the data.ts file. Assign it to the variable resources. Assign this variable to the resources property of the component. In the task settings, map the assigned resources of the task using the resource info field. Also define the object resource fields and map the resource ID from the data source to the ID property and the resource name to the name property. Assign this object to the resource fields property of the Gantt component. Then, add the eColumn tag to show the resource details from the data source and map the assigned resources of the task using the field and header text properties. Check the Gantt chart. The resource column is shown in the tree grid, and it displays the resource names assigned to the task. To define the template content, include the ng template element with the template reference. Then, add the context property let data. Add the wrapper element, and I will include an image only if the resource name is assigned to the task in the data source. Include the image tag, accessing the resource image from the Syncfusion demo source. Add the alternate text attribute. Then add the inline styles to the image element. Add the row height property to customize the default row height and set its value to 60 pixels. As you can see in the Gantt tree grid, the resources column displays the employee's image. Now, I'll show you how to customize the Gantt chart column header. In this example, I'm going to show you how to apply an icon to the resources column. First, remove the header text property. Then, add the ng template element with template reference header template. Include the span tag and name the header title as resources. Open the style.css file. Here, you can add the built-in or a custom icon using the font face CSS rule. Specify the custom font to display the text or icon. Then, define the icon class and use it in the span element. Look at the tree grid header now. An icon was added to the resources column header. You can also add an image instead of an icon here. Comment out the span tag. Just add the image tag with class name resource and access the resources image from the Syncfusion demo. Add the header title resources. Then, in the style.css page, include the styles for the image. Now, the image is displayed in the Resources column header. Finally, I will show you how to add a custom toolbar button to the Gantt chart component using the toolbar click event. Here, you can see the set of built-in toolbar options that I explained in my editing video. If you haven't watched it, you can find it linked in the card above or the description below. In this example, Expand All and Collapse All are built-in toolbar items, and I am going to add a custom filter button. To enable the filter feature in the Gantt chart, open the App Module page, import filter service from the Syncfusion Angular Gantt package, and inject it into the provider's array of ng module. Then, open the App Component HTML page, add the Allow Filtering property, and set its value to true. I include the toolbar click event, which will be triggered whenever a toolbar item is clicked. Assign the method toolbar button clicked. To access the built-in method of the Gantt component, add the reference Gantt object. In the App Component class, define this callback method. Import the view child from Angular Core. Next, define the variable Gantt object and assign the Gantt component. Here, in the toolbar settings, we can specify the details of the custom button, like text, tooltip, ID, and prefix icon. Add the text property value quick filter and the ID property value filter. In the same way, we can add another button to clear the filter in the toolbar settings. Inside the callback method, check whether the button text is quick filter and use the filter by column method to perform a filter based on the task name starting with market. Then, call the built-in method clearFiltering based on the toolbar item text. Check out the toolbar now. When I click the Quick Filter button, the Gantt chart records will be filtered based on my provided task name, market. Then, I can click the Clear Filter button to remove the filter applied. In my upcoming videos, I'll go into more detail about the filter feature. In this video, I showed you how to customize the column headers and data in the Gantt chart component columns using templates. I also showed you how to add a custom toolbar button. You can download a working example of this from the GitHub link in the description for this video below. You can also see if you're eligible for our community license, which will provide you with a free license key to use our products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel.